All right. Okay, last question of the day. Do you think you're Ethereum biased and blind to other platforms? Very good question. Very good question. Honestly, I would say no, because Ethereum has the largest developer community. They have the most traction, and we're always out there reviewing new projects. And we even have our own development team that's out there looking at other projects from a code review perspective, and also for what we're trying to build in the blockchain space, because we're also a blockchain company. As you may know, we have our indices, and we're actively looking at, if we were to put them on a blockchain, where could we build them, right? So we had our team look at Polkadot, Ethereum, and some other platforms. Now we're looking into layer two scaling on Ethereum. And the fact that we're always reviewing projects, we're always keeping an eye out on new and interesting blockchain projects that come about. And there are projects we are bullish on, like Blockstack, like Matic Network, like Polkadot, Cardano. So we've gone through and done tech reviews, but in terms of actual adoption, right now people are building on Ethereum. And until that changes, Ethereum is the play from a pure adoption perspective. Because yes, new projects could launch with good technology, but until developers actually adopt them and begin building on them, it's gonna take a while. So I don't think we're too biased. We're honest, and we're also cautious of risk mitigation, because we know lots of people like to speculate in altcoins. And we're looking at projects that will have long-term staying power. And if right now it's Ethereum's race to lose, we don't want people to go and bet the farm on a different project that could possibly not be around in 6 months, right? So we want to make sure that we find projects with good technology and good adoption before we tell anybody to go FOMO into it, right? So that's kind of our perspective. We think right now is Ethereum's race to lose, especially with ETH 2.0 coming out soon. Definitely, I mean, it will be very tough to bet against Ethereum losing when ETH 2.0 launches. Bill, your perspective? Do you think we're too biased towards Ethereum?
Well, we sound like it. There's no denying that. I went to a conference and I went to South by Southwest in 2019 when crypto was still cascading lower. And I went with an individual. He was a former Wall Street trader who saved a bank by doing the biggest trade in the history of Wall Street in an interest rate futures market. So he saved an entire bank from the crash by making this huge trade. And he got himself into crypto and made so much money. He got in really, really early. He could probably save a few countries himself. We went to see the number two guy at Ethereum. Okay. Mm-hmm. Joe, you may know the last name. I remember in my head as Joe
Lubin. Yeah.
Yeah. And Joe asked everybody in the audience who owns Ether, and every single hand went up. And when he got done, this guy who has an infinite amount of credibility just looked at me and said, "We're in good hands." And that's all I needed to know. That's all I needed to know.
Right. All right. Yeah. All right. Thank you for that story, Bill. And tell us what you think. Do you think we're too biased when it comes to Ethereum? Do you think there are other projects out there we should look at that we haven't looked at yet? Tell us what you think. Okay. Crypto Mike with a super chat again. Thank you, Crypto Family.